This week, I wanted to learn how to read really fast. The plan was simple, finding the best techniques to drastically increase my current speed of 230 words per minute. Which is totally average, by the way, but still pretty bad considering that some people can read more than 1000 words per minute. This was my chance to finally read all the books I abandoned on my shelf and try to become a productive person. But seriously, when you realize how much we read every single day, imagine how many things you could learn or how much time you could save by reading that fast. So I started researching videos, articles, and everything else that could help me get there in 7 days. To keep track of the progress, I took a speed reading test on 2 different websites, and I will take them again a week from now to see if there is gonna be any difference. After about 6 hours of research, I made a list of 4 techniques I needed to learn to master speed reading, and 1 technique to actually comprehend and remember what I read. So I started from the basics, reducing sub-vocalization. This first step gives you access to all the other 5 techniques. During my whole life, I've subconsciously repeated all the words I was reading in my head. And this means that reading out loud will be basically the same as reading in my head, pronouncing every single word.
But here's the thing.
Humans speak at about 150 words per minute, which is much slower than what you can achieve while reading. So the trick here is trying to shut down the inner voice going along in your head and only rely on your vision. I tried to practice for a while and luckily I could already do it from the beginning. But sometimes I found myself unconsciously going back to repeating the words. And that's because sub-vocalization increases the comprehension. But for this step, it's important not to focus too much on that. Anyways, I kept trying, and when I felt confident enough, I decided to move to the next fundamental step, grouping the words instead of reading every single one of them. These techniques were already blowing my mind. I've been trained my whole life to read each word individually. But the reality is that you can get way faster if you start grouping the words and read them as once. To do that, you could draw one or two lines on the page. I mean, you could simply imagine the lines without actually drawing them. Grouping the words in 2 or 3 sections. I started a book and I decided to practice with 3 sections, because it's obviously easier, but still, it took me a while to get used to it. I could almost immediately understand the meaning of the sentences, but at first, I kept unconsciously jumping back to reading every single word. I tried on books and then on the screen, and it took a while, but slowly, the technique started to feel more natural. After 2 hours, I took a speed reading test, and by combining the first and the second technique, I could see the first good results.
419 words per minute, I wasn't expecting it. That's great!
At this point, I kept repeating a few tests online, but my speed remained basically the same, and that's why I decided to move to the third step. Using a tracker. This step is really powerful, but it simply consists in taking your finger or a pen and use it to track the words you are reading. Imagine if you had to count every word on the page. It would be much easier to do it if you helped yourself with a tracker. And the same goes for reading. While you read, your eyes tend to jump back and forward or focus too much on the same point. And all these jumps work against the reading speed. But by using a pen or your finger, you effectively give the eyes a precise point to follow, making the movement much smoother. I started holding the pen under my hand, keeping it flat on the page, and I tried to focus only on its tip. By underlining each line I was reading, I realized that the tracker was also helping me dictating the pace and keep the speed consistent. I spent a few minutes trying this technique, but this time my comprehension was insanely low. At first, I didn't know why. I thought the pen was the problem, so I tried with my finger and nothing changed. But then I tried to change the book and I immediately felt a huge difference. Maybe it was because of the font or the topic. I have no idea. But anyways, I kept practicing for a while with the new book, and then I decided to test my reading speed on paper. This time, I've been able to read a page in 55 seconds, which is about 440 words per minute. But honestly, this was a fake result, because my comprehension was insanely bad. And then, it happened exactly what happened during my typing fast video. I remembered that I'm Italian. With an Italian book, the test gave 26 seconds for 203 words, which means 468 words per minute without decent comprehension. This result was insanely better compared to what I've got in the beginning. But if I wanted to improve speed and comprehension, I still needed to learn 2 other steps. One of them being reading in the middle. What I mean by that is that if you focus on my finger, you can still see everything there is around me. That's thanks to your peripheral vision. And you can actually take advantage of this feature you have to read faster. Using your peripheral vision could increase the reading speed by 300%, because it allows you to understand a full sentence while pointing your eyes only in the middle of it, reading less words and therefore saving a lot of time. By following the tips in this video, I drew 2 lines on the page, basically skipping the first and the last word of each sentence. If you start reading from the second word and stop to the second last one, you'll be still able to see the first and the last words even if you're not actively reading them. I read about 30 pages like this, always imagining two lines almost at the edges of each sentence. And when I got more confident, I started excluding the first and the last two words instead of one. But I'm not gonna lie, it's hard. At times, I felt I wasn't understanding a single word, and I often had to go back and read the text again. But as I read online, I tried to focus only on the speed at this stage. And at the end of the fifth day, I felt I was reading pretty fast.
I feel like I have acquired some sort of superpower. Everything I read right now, I read it extremely fast. It's great!
The last step before trying the final test and see how much progress I actually made is all about increasing the comprehension. The technique consists in reading slightly faster than your comprehension allows for a few minutes. This way, you will slowly get used to a new level of speed. And after slowing down, your comprehension will be increased. I practiced this technique for 20 minutes, going really fast and then slowing down. And after a while, I finally decided to try the reading test one last time. I started the experiment at a speed of 230 words per minute. And at this point, I was extremely curious to see how fast I could read after 6 days by combining all the 5 techniques. And to find that out, I took 3 types of tests. The first one online, in English, the second one with an English book, and the third one with an Italian book. And the first test went pretty well.
436, I'll take it.
But I found pretty difficult to apply the speed reading techniques while reading on a screen. For the second test, reading an English book, I tried to maintain a great level of comprehension, and I've got a slight different result.
430.
Which wasn't bad, but not great. But luckily, things went differently with the third test, with the Italian book. And this gave me by far the best result.
541. 541, that's insane. Let's go. Let's go.
I basically doubled my reading speed in 6 days, and you can easily do it too. And this is huge for me, because I've never read a lot of books, even if I know that they're great. But after this, things will definitely change. Subscribe and click the bell for more content and videos like this. And follow me on Instagram, I'm really active there, and I post skills that I don't share on YouTube. You know what else is great? These beautiful posters that I got from Displate. I genuinely love this company and the quality of its products. You can choose from more than 800,000 designs available in all possible areas. The customer experience is sensational, from the fast delivery to the unboxing and the packaging. And obviously, the unbelievable print quality of the Displates. I picked these 3 for myself and one as a gift for my girlfriend, because I'm sure she will absolutely love it. I chose this one because I'm a huge fan of space and sci-fi. The second one because of the colors and the feelings it gives me. And I gave my own special meaning to the third one. A bunch of fails lead to success. They are really easy to set up with their magnet mounting system, and they look extremely good. When I had to pick mine, I was honestly spoiled for choice. And that's why I created 8 collections on my Displate profile, each one with a bunch of beautiful designs in it. By getting yourself a Displate, you're not only supporting my channel, but also the environment. For each Displate sold, one tree is gonna be planted. And since they are sponsoring this video, Displate is offering you a 26% discount if you get 1 or 2 plates, and 36% if you buy 3 and more. Click the link in the description and get yours today. Thank you for watching. I'll see you soon with a new skill.